Hi, I'm Marge Easley with the League of Women Voters. The League is a nonpartisan organization that has provided voters with unbiased election information since 1920. We've invited candidates to talk with us so you can learn more about them. Joining us now is Jeff Smith, candidate for governor. Nice to have you here.
Hi, Marge. I really appreciate the opportunity to be here. It's a great joy.
Great. Well, tell us a little bit about yourself. Have you run for office before? And if so, what? And if not, why are you running for governor?
No, I have not ran for office before. I grew up in Elgin, Oregon, a little town out in mm-hmm. northeast Oregon. Grew up on a cattle ranch. Went to Oregon Institute of Technology. From there, after graduating from there, I moved to Los Angeles, worked in the aerospace industry. I worked all over the United States. I worked on three continents in four different countries. And after doing all that, I came back to Oregon and started an aerospace manufacturing facility. I started with a bare field. I built a building. I bought machines. I installed machines, started making parts. And along the way, I was a careful observer of Oregon politics. And okay. So what I'm doing now of running for governor, I've been thinking about for doing for 10 years. And
really?
So I feel like this is the time.
Great. Okay. Well, you've got a crowded field there. So there are 10 candidates running for the Republican primary. Tell us about some of your priority issues. And I know that you are interested in reducing health care and medical insurance costs.
Well, really, my one issue is winning. It's been 36 years since a Republican was elected. 1982, Vic Atieh, that was the last Republican. And so the whole point of me running is to do something entirely different. I am the radical that does not look like the typical Republican. I have a different agenda, and mainly the agenda is looking out for issues that a broad swath of Oregonians are suffering under. These things are things that trip up the average citizen of Oregon. It makes their life miserable. When you go to the doctor, you pay 4 to 12 times what you would pay in another country for exactly the same hardware, mm-hmm. exactly the same procedure. These things are just bankrupting Oregon families. It is just causing a tremendous amount of burden on them, and there's things that we can do about it. That situation is driven by laws here in Oregon that we can change. And so my emphasis on running a different campaign with the emphasis of trying to be competitive in Multnomah County has to focus on things that just a broad group of people are suffering under.
Okay. Can you tell us about some of your priorities? Education is a big chunk of the budget. So tell us some of your thoughts on funding for education.
Well, funding for education is driven by PERS. Mm-hmm. The discussion of PERS in and of itself is a non-starter for a Republican to get elected on. But there are many things that we can do to improve our K-12 education system. We are ranked 43rd out of 50 on academics and safety. there's several things that we could do. For one thing, right now, the schools try to have a one solution for every child, and that solution is they're going to send them to college. Mm-hmm. For two-thirds of our kids, that's a bad answer. For two-thirds of our kids, what we, the voters, passed 2 years ago to fund vocational education, okay. that is a good answer. It can lead to trades that these kids can make a living wage out of, and they don't have to spend thousands and thousands of dollars to go into debt to try to get a college education. There's better solutions. Our schools need to be open to those solutions, and they need to, for instance, when I was in high school, my senior year, I had three shop classes.
Wow.
I had two wood shops and a metal shop. Just with the skills that I learned in my local high school and shop class, I could have got a real job. We need to get back to that. The vocational okay. training that we, the voters, we voted on it, and then they didn't fund it. That's a no-brainer to start right there.
Okay. All right. Well, on the table next session is something that the legislature didn't deal with this session, and that is doing a cap and invest or cap and trade type bill to try to offset some of the climate change issues. So what are your thoughts on that?
I am setting myself apart from all of the other Republicans. All the other Republicans are going to give you a real clear, hard answer on that, and I'm going to say that's a non-starter. If you want to get elected as a Republican in Oregon, that's a non-starter. You ought to avoid that issue. And that's what if the legislature comes up with something, I'll read the bill, I'll examine it, but I'm going to do what's best for Oregon working families, people who are living paycheck to paycheck and just need a helping hand. Those are the people that I'm going to look out for. And if it's good for them, fine. If it's not good for them, then it's not going to make it.
Okay. What are some other areas where you differ with the other Republican candidates?
Republicans for the last 30 years have taken hard stands on abortion, gun rights, PERS, tax cuts, and every one of them got beat. And so I avoid those issues because there is no way that we're going to have a policy start with a wide group of Oregonians on those issues. Mm-hmm. There are much more pressing issues that we really ought to be working on. For instance, 1 in 4 kids drop out of our high school. Mm-hmm. What kind of a future are those kids going to have if they drop out of high school? Those things are hurting Oregonians today. And those are the things that we really can solve without reinventing the wheel. They really are within our grasp to just have some leadership issues come up, and we would be able to solve those issues and make it life for the average Oregonian much better. So K-12 education is certainly a very high on my priority list.
Okay. All right. Right now, we have a real partisan divide, and not only in the country, but in Oregon and at the legislative level as well. Some of these wedge issues can really polarize things. What would you do as governor to diffuse that and to have a more bipartisan effort and kind of close some of those divides? And I know you mentioned that you would avoid certain issues, but sometimes those can't be avoided.
Well, the biggest wedge issue is Donald Trump.
Yeah. I wasn't going to mention that.
I am not strongly aligned to Donald Trump. One of my competitors is. That is one of the ways that I'm setting myself apart from these mm-hmm. 9 other people that are running. That's not a description of my views on various policies that Donald Trump may or may not have. What I'm saying is if you start there, you alienate so many people right from the start that this is just not going to be a productive conversation. You got to take him off the table, and you've got to find ways to reach out to people that may have a different viewpoint than you, but you really do have common ground with them. And that's what I'm focused on, building common ground with people who are in Multnomah, Washington, Clackamas counties, people right here in this area. If I can build common ground with those people, mm-hmm. we really can make the lives of Oregonians better. And that's where I want to start, is places that we can build common ground.
Okay. All right. Well, you have 30 seconds left to give a little sound bite. Would you like to do that?
Yeah. You can go to Jeff Smith for... you can just Google Jeff Smith for governor. Mm-hmm. A lot of my issues will come up. You can go to jeff4gov.com.
Okay.
And check out, I've delineated other issues on my webpage. There are a whole host of reasons why you ought to vote for Jeff Smith, but I am the radical that doesn't look like the typical Republican. Okay. And therefore I can be elected.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you so much for being here. It's been interesting.
It's been wonderful. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you.